if you go to a hotel or Airbnb or whatever, what kind of comments is that? Bugs. Like, the bugs are very different from one another. I don't know. I just said you're dropping some really weird comments tonight, TBDH, man. I don't get it, man. Like, things like, what do you expect, bugs and stuff like that. Like, I don't know what's up with you, man. You should have done what happened to the restaurant below, burned that place down. So I started looking into it, okay? Like, looking at, like, how do you get rid of it? Like, you know, what's the consequence? What does it, like, how does it propagate? Like, how does it go from a place to another? How does it reproduce? How do you get rid of it? And shit like that. And when, as soon as I read the, like, documentation on bed bugs, I freaked out. I took my mattress and I threw it off the balcony down the street. I just threw it in the street. I was so fucking pissed. And then from the second floor, I just dropped it. I was like, fuck this shit. And then I called the landlord and I was like, all right, now we got bed bugs issues in your fucking apartment. You just, like, we need to break the lease. We need to break the fucking lease. And the lease was, I think it, we were in, I think we were in September. If I'm remembering correctly, I think we were in September and the lease was good until, like, we signed a 1-year lease, so it was all the way to April. And the landlord is like, nah, you can't just break the lease. Well, I was like, yeah, I think I can. There's a bunch of issues in this apartment, so I think I can. And also, there's the patio door in the back. The lock was broken, so it was held by a 2x4 at some point. So I was like, yeah, I think we can break the lease. And he was like, kind of trying to... He was trying to... you know, like, kind of bullying me into, like, nah, you're not gonna break the lease or whatever. So, like, I just waited an extra day and I was like, hey, let's meet at the bar tomorrow. And I wrote a letter. I got it kind of checked by a lawyer to read my letter and see if what I wrote and everything was fine. So, I told the guy, like, meet me tomorrow at your bar around this time. I came with 2 copies of the letter I wrote and a pen. And I was like, hey, let's sit at this table here. I was like, okay. I wrote this letter here. I got 2 copies. All you have to do is sign both copies. I'm going to sign both copies. You keep one, I keep one. And here's what we're going to do. I took pictures of the shit that's fucked up in your apartment. The bathroom wall is not, you haven't redone it properly, so it's gonna break again and it's not safe. There's some mice in the apartment. You're not doing anything about it. The floor is sinking. The floor is slowly sinking. We have bed bugs. I got robbed and it took forever for you to change the lock. And the patio door in the back is held closed by a 2x4. Because the lock is broken. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna send the document, like all the list of the issues and the photos I took. I'm gonna send them to, it's like the organization to protect tenants. It's like we have a tenant protecting agency to prevent abuses from the landlords, you know? So, So I'm gonna send them a copy of my report, you know, my document with the photos and everything, and the things that you're not willing to fix, that you said you would fix. I'm gonna send also a copy of that document to the fire department, because there's a safety hazard, because my emergency exit is the patio door and it's held closed by a 2x4, so I don't have a safe, reliable safety exit. So I'm gonna send this to the fire department. So what's gonna happen now is the fire department is gonna give you big fines for being unsafe, and it's gonna force you to fix those issues as quickly as possible. And the agency protecting tenants, basically they're going to request me to pay the rent to them until you fix the issue. So they're going to hold on to that rent that I owe you until you fix the issue. So you're not going to touch any rent as long as you don't fix this shit, you know? So we can do all this, or you can sign this letter right now that says that you agreed to break the lease. I'm moving out at the end of the month and you never hear from me again. I already paid this month. We never have to deal with each other again. No hard feelings. I don't want to live in your shitty apartment. It's up to you. You wanna deal with the official way or whatever, and not touch any money, and I have to spend money fixing everything very quickly, or do you want to just forget about me and never see me again, and then we're good. We're just moving. And he's like, he just looked at me, and I remember his face though. It's like he's like bald with like gray hair, like just like a grumpy, tough guy, you know? And he's like, just give me the fucking pen. And he's like, he signed both copies, and just gave it back to me. And he's like, wait, I'm gonna sign both and I'm gonna give you your copy. I don't give a fuck about your fucking copy. He's so pissed. And I was like, all right, cool. I got your copy. We're fair and square. I'm getting the fuck out. I don't owe you anything. What about the deposit? We didn't have any deposit. No, he didn't choose the hard way. He signed the paper. He just wanted to get rid of me. I think I was not a... Like, for him, I was probably a lot of complications compared to, like, his social-assisted tenants that, you know, like, don't mind living in shit and just shut up about it, you know? For the deposit, Jays, deposits are not too common. Maybe they are now, but... for as long as I live in Montreal, the only time I use deposit is when I didn't have the credit. Like, if they did a credit check, I didn't have a high enough credit to be reliable, or I didn't have anyone to be my kind of my sponsor or the person they can go to if ever I don't pay, you know. But normally they do. They do a credit check, and if your credit is reliable, there's no deposit. If your credit is not reliable, you have to find someone that's willing to like sign the lease with you to be like your like kind of, I forgot the term, but to be like your sponsor or representative or whatever. So I didn't lose any deposit. I just left at the end of the month. I packed my shit, and it's fucked up because I found an apartment. And I was so worried to bring some with me to bring, because, I mean, those will stay, like, in the cracks of everything, you know? Like they don't... It's really hard to get rid of. And also, like, from what I read online at that time, I think, like, the eggs can sustain, like, 40 days without any food, and the... Once they're the actual bugs and not the larva, not the eggs, but the actual bug itself, it can sustain like 2 or 3 weeks without food. So it can live a really long time. Like even if you have only one that's stuck in the crease of a bag or whatever, it can live a really long time without like getting your blood. So it's like it can take... You can move to a different place and like weeks later suddenly you're gonna see them pop again because you carried two with you that you didn't know of in the crease of a bag or something like that. So I got super paranoid. I found a new apartment, and what I would do is like, because I had like kind of, they allowed me to move in a few days early. So what I would do is like, I had like kind of a 5-day window where I had access to both apartments. I would go wash my clothes at the laundromat nearby, and I would ask them to use extra hot water and like put everything in the dryer, like whatever, you know, like for the sheets and the blankets and the towels especially. and I would grab my bag from the laundromat, from the laundry place, and bring them, like, take the subway and bring big plastic bags full of clothes and sheets and stuff, and go straight to my new apartment. I didn't want anything to go back in that apartment. You know, if it's clean and it's, like, taken care of, like, I don't want it to go back in the apartment. I go straight to the new place. So I did a bunch of little trips like that, like in the subway, and every day I would bring a couple of bags and go back. And then at the end, we did, like, a final big move. But I made sure, like, to clean everything, to like, wipe all the surfaces, check all the corners of, like, bags, boxes, furniture, like in the back of your clothes drawers and stuff like that, like every little corner, like everything I checked, and then I would put it in the truck to go to the new apartment. And I was paranoid. I was waking up every hour in my new apartment. Like, as soon as I felt like something is touching me or something like that, I would wake up and start, like, turn on the lights in my room and, like, start looking at everything, looking at all the corners of my mattress, every little shit, you know, like, I was, like, super fucking paranoid. But it didn't follow me. I was able to get rid of it. It didn't follow me to the new place. I was free. But, yeah, this apartment was, like,